her AL because she's called Anna Louise, so just the first two initials.
Debra and I met when we crossed the English Channel in a world record attempt in a Chinese dragon boat a few years ago.
We just really hit it off. We sat quite close to each other in the boat, and that's kind of where our friendship really grew.
I could sleep in this quite happily. I haven't mentioned that to you, have I? My problem with falling asleep when I'm in cars.
Oh my God. As long as you're not travel sick, that's the main thing.
We're doing the Monte Carlo Rally Historique, which is for the classic cars, for the older cars, and we're doing it in a 1957 Alfa Romeo.
Here she is.
Oh, she's so cute!
I know.
So tiny.
I don't know why.
I thought it'd be a lot bigger.
No.
Is she going to be our little baby that's going to take us to victory?
Yep.
We're going to be there on the podium like this with champagne. Whoosh! Beep, beep,
beep, beep, yeah! I wasn't going to tell you, but I do have a bit of a problem with reading maps when we're going along.
Oh my God!
The Monte Carlo Rally starts in late January, early February, so we're in October now. We have a bit of preparation to do. Everything in bold is a regularity.
Oh, okay. Right, I got it. Right.
My knowledge is weak, my experience is non-existent, and I'm starting from such a low base that it can only go up from here, really.
Controllo passaggio, controllo passaggio, controllo orario.
Oh, it's just completely overwhelming at the moment, isn't it?
Are we seriously going to have one of these in the car?
I'll grab the jack and what's the spinny thing called? The
spanner.
The spanner.
Maybe I'm not the right person for this job.
You know, such a mechanic.
It's me, Debra the mechanic.
Oh, hang on, why is that dying?
Well, the car obviously won't start.
Might be because AL maybe pumped a little bit too much fuel into the engine. Right, we're going to be pulled now, so close the door.
Now, AL's going to be very focused on driving the car, but if she doesn't drive the car in the right direction on the right road and doesn't get there at the right time, we're going to get penalty points. So.
I think AL is a very good driver.
Oh shit, it would help if I put the car in gear. Rolling backwards, that's not good.
I think they'll be a formidable team.
Yeah, crashing before the rally starts isn't cool. Yeah, I do feel under pressure in order to make sure that I keep Debra safe, as well as myself. I mean, it'd be great to finish the Monte Carlo Rally, and I make jokes with Debra saying that we won't be friends if she doesn't, you know, manage to find our way back to the pits.
Basically, if you get us lost, our friendship's over.
No!
The one thing that worries me most is that I'm going to fail in some way as a driver. On those roads, especially at night when it's dark and it's icy and you're tired and you've got literally a few bricks to stop you going over, that's what frightens me.
I had a little baby this year and I don't want to die. I don't want to leave her without a mother, and that's a real concern to me now. So I have to put an awful lot of trust in Anna Louise and her driving skills, and actually, I do. I really believe in her.
This is going to be so much fun. I love it. I love it already.
Yeah, it's fun. It is fun. She's great to drive.
I can't wait. Bring on the rally. That's all I say.
Two girls in the Monte Carlo Rally. It's going to be a good one.